Mr. Hutton made his comments during a conference on the future of NATO at Wilton Park in Sussex. The event was to mark NATO's 60th birthday and involved international policymakers looking at the future direction of the organisation. The UK Defence Secretary said not all of Britain's European partners were pulling their weight.
Not really, no, and that's a view that we've been expressing to many of them recently, and actually over some period of time. Now, every member state has got to come to its own decision on this. What I don't want there to be any doubt about is the importance of our mission in Afghanistan. No one can regard this as an issue that's not important to the future of NATO. It's fundamental to the future of NATO. I don't believe it's right and proper that we can go on saying to the US, you can carry all the principal heavy lift responsibility when it comes to kinetic operations. I don't think that's part and parcel of the deal. If you want the insurance cover, you want to take advantage of it, you've got to pay the premium. That's how I see it. And these are difficult political issues. We accept that. We've got to have proper discussions with our friends and allies around the NATO table. But there are some unavoidable decisions that need to be made. They're tough and difficult. But the peace and security of Europe has not come without a price.
Mr. Hutton said success for NATO in Afghanistan was critical, not just for the future of that country, but also for the future of the alliance.
We know from our own experience, many of our NATO allies do as well, that a lot of the terrorism and violence that we had to deal with a few years ago came from this region, particularly from Afghanistan. So we've got to be there, we've got to try and reconstruct Afghan society, we've got to help the new democratic Afghan government itself deal with these challenges. We are in the middle of security operations there, kinetic operations. We're also very heavily committed to a range of reconstruction, development and social programs which have to go hand in hand in Afghanistan.
Also speaking at the conference was Lord Ashdown, who had a leading role in Bosnia-Herzegovina. He said NATO was facing serious problems in Afghanistan.
The fact is that NATO is not succeeding, NATO's failing. I don't think we've lost in Afghanistan, but we're certainly not succeeding there. Not all of that is NATO's fault, but it's NATO that'll pay the price. This is after all, NATO's primary and most important function at the moment. And the consequences, incidentally, for the region of failure and for NATO of failure are very grave and very worrying. Now, what do we do about that? That's the question. Well, I think we have to have a substantial change of strategy. Is more troops necessary? Yeah, it is. A surge, perhaps Obama will institute one, is necessary, but not sufficient. Do we need more resources? Yes, we do. We're putting into Afghanistan as an international community 1/25th the amount of troops and 1/50th the amount of aid per head of population that we put into Bosnia. You can't do things on the cheap.
The UK is the second largest troop contributor to Afghanistan after America, with nearly 8,000 soldiers, more than twice as many as Germany, France and Italy.